This video was brought to you by Stoltenberg, Abed Route Planner, Mr. Green, Camp Power, and Marcus Biel. Wow, very impressive. We are back home in a different car, and let's take a look at the results. So the BMW iX managed to do it in roughly 5.7 seconds. And look at that compared to the spec. It's supposed to be 6.1, so this is very impressive. It's fast and spec, and maybe I should highlight in comparison, which car do you want to compare against? Okay, you have the BMW iX, this one, the big brother. So the big brother is roughly 1 second faster, as expected, but it costs a lot more. It has more power, but I still think that 5.7 seconds is schnell enough, and maybe we should compare against other cars. Which cars then? I think you want to see iX3. Look here. So the iX3 is again almost a second slower again. So yeah, what is the takeaway here? It's a fast car, fun car to drive. That's my impression. And then as for braking test, just look here. What the heck, man? A 2,500 kilo car versus Model 3, which is more than 500 kilos less, but the braking performance in the iX is just outstanding. Okay, well, it could be because we have 255 fat tires, but yeah, it means that you don't have to worry that we have a big and heavy car, because this is actually what I was thinking before I did this test, like, how well does it really brake? Well, now we know. Now we know. You don't have to worry if you buy this car. You know, the safety of this German electro auto has been taken care of. No problem at all. And then as for noise, yes, the comfort of this German electro auto has also been taken care of. Now, I should point out that, you see, it's right up there, almost the same as EQC. I'm not sure why the EQC was better. Well, EQC was with 20-inch wheels, but 45 profile. But okay, there's a big butt crack here always, which is that in this test, I started using the left lane, which is, I measure it to be 2 dB quieter, but it depends which car it is, of course. So for silent cars, could be 1 dB difference. And that means that maybe the iX here is right on par with the e-tron with the acoustic glass, because the e-tron here, I did it, I think it was 2 years ago, roughly. And actually the surface, but this, okay, I shouldn't point out that with the e-tron and the most other cars here, pretty much, well, actually all the other cars here in this little table, they all were tested on the right lane, which is noisier. So don't just trust this blindly. I don't say, the iX is 1 dB better. I think it's right there. If we would, you know, go back in time 2 years ago and drive on the right lane like we did with the e-tron here, we might probably get around 65.5 dB. So what it means is that this car is fast, fairly fast for a big, not this car here, because this car is actually a Model S. Ludicrous Raven performance. But the BMW iX is pretty quick, and it has good braking performance, and it's also quiet. all that stuff. And you know, you might be wondering, but why didn't I compare the iX versus the Model Y? Well, actually, space-wise, they do compare. But space-wise, the BMW iX also can compete with, let's say, what is that Chinese car again? It was a Chinese car, right? Space-wise, you can compete with them, but does it make any sense to compete them? No, because the Model Y is a lower price range. It has lower comfort, but the iX is just top-notch. German electro-auto, premium, you know, not luxury, but premium. Soundproofing is good, ride and everything is just yeah. So that's why I don't compare them against each other, but I did compare the iX repeatedly over and over against Fat e-tron, and then also Model X. Why Model X? Because the price is kind of similar, but now the Model X has grown kind of expensive also. Yeah, but then you get also more for bang for the buck. So actually the Model X nowadays more or less competes against the xDrive 50. Yeah, in range and everything, power and everything, except for the Model X is actually faster. But you get some pros with the Model X, but you also have some cons with the Model X. But okay, so anyway, I think that's going to be it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching and talk to you later.